Welcome back to the next video showcase. So now we will have a look at our simulation results of our virtual epileptic patients. So in the previous video, we discussed the epilepto local model, and we've generated a large-scale brain network with different configurations of the epilepto in different areas. So now let's first have a look at the simulation results of this article. How the seizure simulated seizure look like. So this can basically be seen here in figure 5. And as the empirical recording, they were also able to record simple seizures with seizure-like activity in a specific brain area, then also complex seizures with seizure-like activity spreading through our network. And finally, they also applied a simulated stimulus to one area, which would then trigger a seizure in others. Okay, now let's switch over to our TVB user interface, and I've already created one simulation here, and we will now have a look at the time series and three-dimensional representation of the cortical surface. So as you can see, on the left side, the cortical surface, and on the right side is the time series. There's not much of activity going on for the moment, but this is mainly due to the fact that we are looking at the slow Z variable. So we can change this here. And now we're looking at the fast subsystem of the epileptor. And you can see there's a lot of dynamics going on, but this is mainly due to the fact that we are starting with random initial conditions. So if we recall the phase plane we just explored before, is if we start anywhere randomly in the phase plane, we can also, for some chance, start in the epileptic zone or in the epileptic limit cycle. And so we will see fast oscillations in the beginning. But soon the whole network will stabilize, and we will see that only epileptic seizures will be generated in our predetermined regions, so which is mainly amygdala, hippocampus, parahippocampal regions, and then propagations on part of the temporal cortex. So you can look from down here. We will make this show off from the face of John Doe. And as you can see now, there's no activity going on. So the system reached a stable equilibrium. And what we will now see in a moment is that there is electrical activity or seizure-like activity beginning in this brain area and then spreading through the rest of the network. You can also see it on the right side down here, time series. And what you can really see is that this hyperactivity of the neurons is really bound to the areas where we set this epileptogenicity index to a higher value than this threshold. Okay, this was one short representation. Now we switch back to the simulator page, and I want you to show, I want to show you what happens if we play along with this epileptogenicity parameter. So I created another simulation, and for all the other regions I set this epileptogenic parameter closer to this critical threshold, and with the epileptogenic zone staying the same as before. So pick the visualizer again. So again, as before, due to random initial conditions, we start with many oscillations through the whole cortex, but soon, again, the system will stabilize. Okay, so we remember the epileptogenic zone were the same as before, but all regions are very close to this critical threshold now. And what we're seeing now down here is an epileptic seizure generated in the same area as before, and this will now spread at first through the other epileptogenic zones and also through the propagation zones. But then, as you can already see in the timeline, it will spread through the whole left hemisphere, excuse me, and then also across the right hemisphere. Okay, this was one short example of how we can control the activity and dynamics of our brain system by varying this epileptogenicity index parameter for different brain regions. I hope this was an informative video tutorial for you. Thank you for watching.